Hi there, and welcome to ESL RPG. I'm David, and today we will continue looking at Roll20. I promise this time, Arry will not be helping. Also, no Gary either. Anyway, last time we went over two ways to build character sheets. Today, we will discuss chat tools. Let's start with why to even use the chat in Roll20. There's the obvious. It gives a written record, meaning something everybody can read and check. It will save chats between game sessions so you can go back and check it for things people have said or done. So, like every other group chat tool. What's different? Well, let's talk about those chat tools. Currently, I'm logged in as a player. We will go over GM-specific commands later. As you can see, there's a list of commands here. In addition to leaving a record, you can also roll dice publicly, roll dice secretly, whisper, and separate your character and yourself. What do I mean? Let me give examples. First, characters. You can see here at the bottom, I can select here whether I type as me or as any character I control, in this case, Barfy. The most useful thing is to set it to your character and only change this if you play multiple characters. Now, most commands start with a slash. As you see, if I say hi, it will show my character Barfy saying hi. Your first command is for speaking out of character. To say something out of character, start with slash O, a space, and whatever you say. For example, slash O, hi, makes David C say hi. Characters do more than talk, though. They also, well, do things. For that, start a command with either slash ME or slash EM. Don't forget the space and follow with your character's actions. For example, slash EM runs and slash ME runs both give us Barfy runs. One more thing players and characters do is whisper to each other. To do that, type slash W, one space, the name of the player or character, one more space, and the thing you want to say. This works with the GM too, as in slash W GM, I am going to pickpocket the priest. Now, when we talk roles, we're going to talk a little more about advanced tools, mechanics, and syntax. So really quick, let's talk GM-specific stuff. If you're not a GM and don't feel like teaching your GM how to GM better,
feel free to skip ahead until you see my beautiful face again.
All right, dive in.
The first thing a GM may do is describe stuff. Wonderful tool there. Slash DESC. Anything typed after that shows up as a general description without someone saying it.
It's like emotes for the world.
Now, about those characters, slash AS lets you speak as a character. You need to type slash AS quote character name end quote stuff they say for it to work. But any character is fine, including characters you haven't made a sheet for. Also, if you want that character to emote an action, almost the same, just start with slash EMAS. Oh, and one more interesting thing. Let's create a character and name it Elvin. We can set that character to be controlled by any player whose character speaks Elven. Anytime you use the command slash W and target a character, it can be seen by any player who controls that character. Congratulations! You now have a language command. Just type your message and only your Elven-speaking players will understand. For example, slash W Elven, you shouldn't be here. Okay, back to stuff for everyone. We'll now discuss more advanced tools, in particular, syntaxing and roles. There, beautiful face is going away now.
First rule of syntax. If you want to show someone the correct command, start from a backtick. For anyone using an American keyboard or similar, that's the tilde key next to the one. For anyone with a keyboard without that key, hold Alt and press 9, then 6 on your numpad. Make sure numlock is engaged. For example, to show someone the correct way to emote a smile, slash EM smiles, type backtick slash EM smiles. Part two there, to include multiple things in one action, like an emote, something you say in character, and a role, you can separate everything into new lines by pressing Shift Enter. For example, let's say your character says a one-liner before charging the enemies. Type my ultimate one-liner. Then, on the next line, slash ME, charges the enemies. Okay, and finally, roles. There are three role commands. Slash role and slash R both make public roles everyone can see. Slash GM role makes roles only you and the game master can see. Let's start easy and say you know your modifiers. You tell everyone you're sneaking inside, and your GM says to make a stealth check. Like a pro, you know that's 1d20 plus your stealth modifier, plus 6. Here's what you do. Slash R, 1d20 plus 6. Very important, no spaces in the formula here. Type that in, and you get the result here. Okay, let's make it fancier. You want people to know it's stealth. After the formula, one space and its label, slash R, 1d20 plus 6, stealth check. Your sneakiness has earned you an advantage on attack! After the dice, K followed by a number tells the system to keep one dice, by default, the highest. Additionally, you can add H for specifically the higher dice, or L for the lower dice. So, for an attack with advantage, slash R, 2d20, KH1 plus 6. It hits! Time for math. Here, order of operations is now important. Let's take your average sneak attack with a dagger. That's the dagger damage plus sneak attack plus dexterity modifier. For a level 3 rogue with 17 dex, that's slash R, 1d4 plus 2d6 plus 3. If you have a crit, default to the system of crits for your game. For number of dice doubled, just double each number. Slash R, 2d4 plus 4d6 plus 3. For dice result doubled, slash R, open parentheses, 1d4 plus 2d6, close parentheses, times 2, plus 3. And for everything doubled, slash R, open parentheses, 1d4 plus 2d6 plus 3, close parentheses, times 2. Or times 3 if you have a special weapon.
But now your GM whispers,
roll a con save.
While you shake in your boots wondering what magical trickery this is,
make sure to type /GM roll 1d20 plus 4 con save.
As you fail, your GM now tells you you failed the resistance for the bard's magical trap, which hits you with both fire and ice damage.
He rolls it using square brackets for the damage type, like /R 3d8, open bracket, fire damage, close bracket, +3d8, open bracket, ice damage, close bracket. And what's this? That crafty bard has a thing for fish, and an extra effect of his spell is a barrage of 3d12 sardines. You know this because the GM types with double brackets for the roll, /DESC.
As the trap explodes outwards, you are covered in open double brackets, 3d12, close double brackets, sardines flying through the air.
The embarrassment sends you into death saving throws, represented as /R. 1d20. Greater than 10. Using the greater than to show anything greater than or equal to 10 is a success. After 3 failures, you are now rolling up a new character. For this one, you use /R. 4d6d1 for each of your stats. The second D tells it to drop the lowest one. But what's this? Your GM is very nice and tells you you can re-roll any ones. Okay, so before the second D, add R1 to tell it to re-roll ones, making it /R 4d6 R1 D1. By the way, if you have a special ability that lets you reroll ones and twos on damage rolls, just add the comparison less than and two. Then it automatically does it. Okay, there's more for special systems like exploding dice or dice rolls modifying the number of dice rolled. But I think that's enough for now. Next time we will combine all of this to make macros, because honestly, that's a lot to remember how to type. In the meantime, a big thanks to our patron, the bird defiant and alchemist extraordinaire, Michael! See you next time!